In this YouTube video, we're going to take a look at whitening teeth in Lightroom. It's a pretty quick and easy process, easy when you know how. Let's jump into it and show you how it's done. So first off, choose your photo and then head on over to the Develop panel and select the Adjustment Brush tool. Click on the area you want to associate the brush with, in this case it's his teeth, and then we'll work at sizing and configuring the brush the way that you want it. So you can use the square bracket keys on your keyboard, or you can come down here to the panel and use the sliders to size your brush and then to adjust the amount of feathering on the brush. So this will change depending on the size of the brush that you're using. You can also then change the flow of the brush, so how much it's going to affect, and the density as well. You can use the auto mask, which I prefer not to because sometimes it gives a pretty hard edge. And then there's the option to erase as well. So you can resize your brush. You can hit the Z key on the keyboard to zoom in and then size your brush again to exactly the size that you want it. And then simply paint over the area of the teeth that need whitening. Here I have the mask overlay turned on. You can click that checkbox down the bottom there, or you can hit the O key on your keyboard to bring that up. So once you've painted over the area that you want to whiten, if you've gone too far in some places like I have here, you can just erase these little extras and just tidy it up to get it looking just how you want it to. Not being particularly precise for the sake of the video, just to show you how. So then turn the overlay off, and then you can come up and select from the drop down the teeth whitening preset. So that's at the top there where it says effect, and it is now set so that the saturation and the exposure are automatically adjusted. So you can see that just dragging around the saturation, how much difference that makes on its own. You can then change other sliders like the dehaze or the whiten to bring that up, but be careful, you don't want to overkill, you don't want to get an unnaturally looking smile. Not everybody wants to look like they've come out of a toothpaste commercial. So that's about it really, there's not a lot to it. You can then save your preset if you've got a whole bunch of photos of the same person in the same lighting situation. You can save it, and then if you've made adjustments, extra adjustments to customize your brush, save that brush and you can get that there as a saved preset that you've custom made. So zoom out, you can turn the brush off, that'll hide the dot, and if you just turn it back on again, if you want to see the difference it makes, come back down to that little switch at the bottom of the panel, flick it on and off, and you can really clearly see the difference that the teeth whitening has made. So there it is, quick and easy. There's not much to it when you know how to do it. It's really a great tool to make your portrait photos just have that extra pop. You can apply the same technique to whiten eyes as well. So you can even set up different presets and use these as you see fit. That's all for today. Again, thanks for watching. If you're new to our channel, please click on subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this, if it was helpful. And of course, if you've got some questions or comments, please leave those for us down below as well.